Yeah. It has come to our attention that a mysterious force is loose somewhere in outer space.
The mysteries of creation are there.
Up in the sky?
Up in the sky.
The moon and the planets are there. And new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Denton Staples since 1980, the Golden Triangle Mall welcomes shoppers with its more than 90 specialty shops and attractions. This newly renovated shopping center is a center that Denton, if you're in Denton, you just can't miss it. Happy Wednesday, everybody. Welcome to The Creation Sensation. I'm your host, Dunashe. We got a wonderful show lined up for you today. In my opinion, closing out the year the right way, I've got my man, Lane Boozer, joining me on the show. What's up, Leno? How you doing, brother?
Everything. Thank you so much for having me on. It's really an honor, and it's exciting to be here, man. Thank you so much.
Well, I couldn't think of a better way to end this bad boy. I had Caleb on last week, one of my brothers, and I got you on this week. So I just feel like we're doing this the right way.
I feel like it as well, man. Thank you so much.
So I've known Lane for about 3 years at this point. And when I met Lane, we met while we were both playing at Two Charlie's.
That's right.
Open mic, once upon a time.
That's right. Bone Doggies open mic at Two Charlie's.
And for guys who don't know, that used to be a thing, a weekly thing. And you might get out at 11 o'clock. You might get out at 2 o'clock, come closing, depending on how many people are out. And I would see Lane. He would always say, you know, you sounded really good. He'd be all dressed up. You'd have your cowboy hat and your boots, looking so mayoral. If that's a word there, but
it's always a word.
Prestigious, man. And I'm like, to be honest with you, you always remembered my name, but I'm pretty bad with names. So since I hadn't just sat down and talked to you yet, I'm like, man, this guy's always nice. I cannot remember his name for the life of me. So there's this one day, one particular Friday, I met a buddy over at Fuzzy's off of the Loop, and I see you come in. I guess it was on your lunch break. And I'm like, hey, man, you know, I'll meet you later. I got to go talk to this guy. And so I come by and I sit beside you and we just strike up a conversation. We knew each other, yeah. But that's when I learned your name. I'm like, I'm never going to forget that name. And we had this conversation. We sat for about dang near an hour.
Something like that.
And you invited me out to your house for your birthday. Now, this was in June.
Probably.
And your birthday ended until October. So you were just looking at you like, I want you there. And I said, well, you know what? If this guy really wants me to come out, he's saying this far away, like, I got to be there.
Well, I got to tell you, there was some selfish reason behind that, you know, because I was hoping that you'd play, you know, at the party.
Well, I did.
Well, and a bunch of us did. A bunch of folks showed up and played. In fact, you mentioned Caleb earlier. I think Caleb was there, too.
Yes, he was.
And we had a nice crowd, and we didn't do a party this year. It would have conflicted with another event here in town. But we're going to do one in 2017 because it's going to be a big number.
Wow.
Yeah. So it'll be around October 25th. I don't know what the date is yet, but somewhere around there. Well, I'll make sure you know about it.
It's always a good time coming over to the Booze House. So Lane has the fortune. I don't know if you would say fortunate all the time, but I think it's fortunate that he lives right next door to his parents.
It's a blessing and a curse.
That's what I'm saying. Depends on what day, I suppose. But they've got this awesome setup, guys, where you can kind of interchange between the backyards, and it's a lot of space for what it is, especially being here in the city. And we just like to have grill outs and jam sessions and afternoons where you're sipping on a glass of whiskey, smoking a cigar, just enjoying whatever weather's provided.
Oh, yeah.
Laid back.
And regardless of the weather, we're equipped for all situations, man.
You got to stay ready so you don't have to get ready.
That's right. We're ready all the time.
And so, yeah, I went over, hung out. You had barbecued that day.
Yeah.
My man can throw down.
You were very kind.
On some BBQ. We had a really good time. So ever since then, I'm like, you know, this guy's legit. You know, I came over. You guys just accept me. You and all of your friends and your parents and everybody, y'all just accepted me right away. So I'm like, y'all are good people. And we've been homies ever since, man.
Ever since.
Many more parties we've celebrated and many more opportunities to come, I hope.
Many.
Yes,
many.
Indeed.
Countless.
So, yeah, he calls me over. He wants me to play. I play, and it was probably maybe the next time I came over that, you know, I didn't really know what you did at that time. I'm just like, is this guy the mayor for real? No. I didn't know what you did. And so you fill me in on what you guys do. And I didn't understand it. It took me a little bit. But once I understood and you guys were fortunate enough, I got to meet some of your buddies. So if you had to describe to somebody what you do during the day, what would you say?
Oh, man. Well, most days I dress like I'm dressed right now, you know. And for those of you who are watching this on the video stream or who can't see me, I'm in a T-shirt and jeans and running shoes, or it might be boots and jeans or shorts and sandals in the summer. Because Don, my dad, and I work together, and we're kind of behind-the-scenes guys in the insurance world. And what we do is help other insurance agents help their clients as best we can so they can do the best they can. Predominantly life insurance, and like I said, being behind the scenes and working all day using the phones and the internet. You know, like I'm saying, I don't put on clothes unless I'm going to see somebody that day. So that's what we do. We help people protect themselves against financial distress in the times they need help the most.
So y'all pretty – okay, I got you. So if somebody was interested in getting that kind of service or whatever, how would they go about it?
Well, we're both licensed insurance agents ourselves, and we have friends all over the state, all over the country, and all over town as well. But if we can help you with life insurance needs, they can certainly call my office. And I'm glad to help anybody. As long as I can help you, I will do my best to help you.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, you know, I got a chance to meet your buddies from NAFA, is what you guys call yourself. And just like your family, your work family just accepted me right away. And next thing I know, you guys are asking me to come down and play in Austin.
That's right. We had you in Austin.
And, you know, for me, it was a wonderful experience. And I still thank you. I'm going to thank you for life for that, because it was great having an opportunity to play in front of, y'all had 500 people down there?
Something like that.
500 people just by myself. And I played for a lot of people. I've been blessed to do that, but just not that many at one time.
Well, you know, you mentioned family. You mentioned my work family, my NAFA family, my biological family, but let's go back to that NAFA family thing. As I recall, we had you over to the house, and I had some NAFA associates in, and we had a little barbecue at the house, and I asked you to come play, and we were putting together that meeting in Austin, and the guy who was in charge of putting that on, his name is Jason Talley. Jason, if you're listening, I hope you are.
Shout out to you.
Jason said, you know, he's like, what am I going to do for entertainment? And I told him what I did the previous year, because it was my assignment that previous year. And he's like, well, why don't we just hire this guy? He's pointing at Dunashay. I'm like, well, we got to pay him something. He says, we got money. So
y'all definitely took care of me. Y'all put me up in the hotel down there. It was Doubletree or something like that.
I think so.
I mean, it was awesome, guys. They put me up. Y'all treated me well. I got to play twice because I got to go down and play in that bar that was down at the bottom of that building as well. So all in all, people, what I'm trying to say is even though I barely knew this guy, he was willing to stick his neck out for me, take care of me. And I just appreciate it, man. I appreciate it. It's mutual. So it was probably about the second or third time I come over and we're jamming. Man, I got something for you to try. And we go to the garage, and you start telling me about this device that you've made, this thing that's called a tambo toe. And you say, hey, man, this is how it works. You want one? Yeah. And I'm not going to be silly and say, no, it's another tool in my arsenal. So I take this thing home, and I start practicing with it. And what the tambo toe is, guys, is, well, it looks like this. Let's see. I'll put a little close to the camera for you. Mine is, of course, a green color, because my brother looks out for me. He knows that's my favorite color there. And it's a nice percussion instrument that if you're a solo act, you can use this and it will make it sound like there are maybe two people playing with you.
It's like a drummer that doesn't argue with you, that shows up on time and doesn't run up a bar tab.
Hey, hey, hey.
And he who does what you tell him to. I'm a drummer. I can say that.
And if you've been around enough and you play with drummers, maybe you've had that experience. No, that's true, too. But it's awesome because you get this slap sound of a kick, and then you also get the bells as your hi-hat. And I've got one of the original versions. I understand.
Actually, that's a third generation version.
Whoa.
Yeah.
This is a third gen. So how far have you guys gone now?
Well, how far back do you want to go with this?
Well, I want to go back to you guys' conception of this thing. Because you don't do this alone, right?
No, I've got a partner in this. It actually happens to be my cousin. His name's Mike Garrison. And, Mike, I hope you're listening tonight or watching online.
Hey, hey, Mike.
Mike actually brought to me this idea. It was Mike's idea originally. And what's funny is Mike's an engineer. And he just conceived this idea. I think where the idea came from is he saw a guy playing, you know, an acoustic guitar, a solo act. And he was trying to manage one of those moon-shaped... was it Latin percussion that makes them? Anyway, a tambourine. And he's got on the floor and he's stepping on it and it kept walking away from him, you know, as he's playing. And Mike goes, I think I might have a solution for that. And so he started touring around his shop and came up with what was basically a block of wood, wedge-shaped like the current design. And he got his Dremel tool out and channeled out those channels where the timbres or jingles are just on a current model, and then set it on the ground and stepped on it. And nothing happened.
Hmm.
And so he put some little rubber feet on it. Thought maybe that would let it. So anyway, nothing happened then. So you mentioned doing stuff over at the Boozer compound. We were having one of our annual 4th of July gigs. Usually Mike and I would get up and play for a bit. And he brings this thing. In fact, I met Mike today. Had him bring me the original.
Wow.
This is the original Tambo Toe. For those of you guys watching. Actually, this is the revised original Tambo Toe that Mike originally brought to me. He actually kind of carved out the logo on the top. He brought me this. He said, Lane, you're the wood guy. You work with wood all the time, man. See if you can make this work. And so I mocked up a few other prototypes and eventually came back to, we figured out, hey, the block's got to move. The block's got to move for those timbres to make any sound.
Uh-huh.
So, well, how do you make the block move? After a lot of trial and error, we came up with the idea that it needs to be some sort of spring-loaded thing, which is what you ultimately have now. There's a plate on the bottom that's fastened to the block, and that's got a space between them, so that plate on the bottom actually acts like a spring.
Uh-huh.
So we came up with this model, and I had some other musician friends try it out, and this still walks away from you. But this is the original one, so that's a piece of history, guys. We got to hold on to that. So then I came up with the second version, which was about 10 inches long. A friend of mine, another player, said, you know, you need a tail on this thing, something your heel can rest on to keep it from walking away. And I thought, that's a great idea. So we toyed with a few of those. And then the question became, well, how long does that tail need to be? Well, at the time, I still play it now, that big blonde acoustic guitar.
Yeah.
Her name's Big Bertha. But she's a jumbo dreadnought. And I thought, wouldn't it be cool if this fit under the headstock in your guitar case so you didn't have to carry a second whatever it was? And so I went and measured my case, and I said, that is the number. That's it. It's 10 inches. That's what you need right there. Well, it turns out not everybody's playing a jumbo, you know. So that wound up being too long. So that after that, length was not really an issue. I gave another one to a buddy of mine in Austin, a guy named Jimmy Lee, who's my harmonica teacher, as a matter of fact. He's a fantastic player. And I was down there one night. I took one to him. He was playing. And he calls me the next day. He says, Lane, you got to make this thing longer. And I can hear it jingling in the background. And I said, well, how much longer, Jimmy? And I hear him pull out a measuring tape. And he's measuring his foot. He's measuring this thing. He said, 16 inches would be good. 16. Make it 16. So I made... We started making them 10 inches and 16. Figured we'd give you your choice.
Okay.
Sent him that. He says, yeah, this is perfect. Some people said, well, 16's too long, but 10's too short. So now we settled on what you got now is 13.
Okay.
And if there's ever another revision, it will probably be 13 and a half. That'll be the final cut. That's it.
Okay.
Why 13 and a half? You're supposed to ask me, why 13
and a half? Well, I was trying to accept all of that, but why 13 and a half, Lane?
Well, because at 13 inches, I get 7 cuts out of a length of lumber that I cut this from, and it leaves about a 4-inch gap.
Okay.
If I make it 13 and a half, I have zero waste, and it keeps us green and environmentally friendly, see?
There we go.
Zero waste, man. We do it as much as possible. Try to remain green. We use inexpensive materials. You know, the thing's inexpensive to begin with. So that's a long answer to a short question. How'd you get to this?
No, that's exactly what we were looking for.
Yeah.
Hey, you guys don't go anywhere. You're listening to the Creation Sensation. We'll be right back with plenty more from my man, Lane Boozer.
All right.
Every Friday and Saturday night, Shelly Tucker, our resident storyteller, will lead the Ghosts of Denton tour. Those happen every Friday and Saturday night at 8 p.m. And if you want to make reservations, you can go to ghostsofdenton.com to check that out. And every Tuesday night here at the Discover Denton Welcome Center, we have our open mic nights. These will be broadcast live on our Facebook page, dentonradio.com, and happen every Tuesday from 6 to 9 p.m. We also have live jazz at the Greenhouse Restaurant and Bar every Monday night. These start at 10 p.m. and go until midnight, so go and check that out every Monday night here in Denton.
Welcome back to the Creation Sensation. Happy Wednesday to you. Happy holiday season to you. Hope you guys have enjoyed a wonderful Christmas and looking ahead to a great New Year's. Joined today by my good friend Lane Boozer, and we're talking about a wonderful idea that he and his cousin had called a Tambo Toe. And it looks like this bad boy. Sounds like that if you guys are listening. And I feel like if you guys are, anybody out there is a solo acoustic player, well, this is a great piece of instrumentation that you can use to add to your sound and give you just a little bit more depth as you're doing your thing. I've used it. I need to use it more. But, you know, as we were going over some things last night, because we're going to do a little jamming here later on, you know, there were times when I'd be going at it and there's so much to think about already. I don't know if anybody listening, if you got to sing and play, and then possibly play some harmonica or something like that. That's a lot of things to be trying to think about. And then you add this in here, and you're trying to get the tempo. And it's very easy to get off. As you were saying earlier, one of the things that you guys encountered with the first gens is that it would slide away from you.
Right.
And so what do you say for anybody out there that may already have one?
Customize it.
So how would you go about doing that, bad boy?
I've seen, if you know Gary Chase here in town, hand percussionist.
GC, thing. What's up, brother?
GC, hey, Gary, hope you're listening. Gary customized his. He actually took his apart, added more jingles to it, fastened it down, and then I think he put Velcro on the bottom of his because he's always got a piece of carpet under him because
right.
He's got a djembe or something like that. And Velcro is good if you're playing on a carpeted surface. Sticky tape. I've seen guys put a short screw on the tail end of it to act like a spur, like you'd have a spur on a drum pedal or something like that to keep it from moving. Of course, that will dig into the floor, so be aware of any damage you may do. But, man, we encourage you to customize it. We just ask that if you do, send us pictures. Send us pictures. Better yet, send us video. We'd like to see you play it.
So where would they send something?
Tambotoe.com. You can send it to lane@tambotoe.com or mike@tambotoe.com or sales@tambotoe.com. I think there's even a photos. Just send it to Lane. Make it keep it easy. lane@tambotoe.com. L-A-N-E.
L-A-N-E, peeps.
At tambotoe.com.
Cool, yeah. So you guys are sound like you're always just trying to improve it and get better with what you're doing. And that's tight, man. So you can customize this bad boy. You can put the screws in there, Velcro, anything like that.
Yeah.
But the most important thing is to really just get to know it. Like I said, because you're trying to think about so many things, and it's easy to kind of get off whenever you're playing. And so it's just important to get – we were talking about it last night. It's like this little middle groove in all of the madness.
Yeah. Well, you know, a lot of people tap their foot or do something physical with some part of their body as a way to – monitor their meter and their tempo when they're playing. And what's interesting is even though you're tapping your toe, you may not actually be in time. You're telling your mind, I'm tapping my toe, so I must be in time. You may not be. And what's neat about this, it's a great teaching tool. And this is what I tell a lot of people, like even if you're not going to use it in a public performance, it's great in a practice environment because it will give you audible feedback. So you say, hey, am I in time? And you listen to yourself tap your toe. Once you find what your groove is, as far as how that fits under your foot, and it's different for everybody. But when you find where you're comfortable playing it, and then you try to maintain that metronome with your foot, it'll give you immediate feedback to let you know whether you're actually on or not. And you talked about having a lot of things to juggle in your mind, you know, when you're playing. Man, this is a great teaching tool.
Yes, indeed. So anybody out there that's having trouble, maybe you haven't been practicing with a metronome like you should, well, this is one for you. This is one for you. So do you feel like you guys will branch out from this and do something more?
As far as in the musical world?
I guess so. With the woodwork, because I mean, what else do you normally do? I mean, I know, but what else do you normally do with your wood?
I do a lot of custom pieces, a lot of furniture. People ask for stuff. My dad recently commissioned a piece for me. He decided he had to have a TV on his back patio.
Papa and he Don. Needed,
yeah, Papa Don. So Papa Don had to have that TV back there, and he wanted a, you know, one of those boxes like you see. You mentioned Fuzzies. They've got and over at East Side and everywhere that people have big televisions outside, they've got some kind of a box that closes up and protects them from the weather. So Don wanted one, and of course he's used to. You mentioned his compound over there. You know, we built some pretty nice stuff over there.
Yes, y'all have.
And my friend, Dr. Steve Rue, Steve, I know you're listening. Steve said, why don't you just make it like all clad in cigar boxes or a big giant cigar box? Because we all love cigars.
Yes, yes.
So that's ultimately what we did, and it turned out really nice.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing the new TV and the cigar box.
You're always welcome, man.
We'll see what's popping this weekend for
you're
New
always
Year's.
Welcome.
So I know you were building up your coffin for the coffin races.
Oh, yeah.
Earlier this year.
Yeah, that we did that for the Denton Dallas and Beyond group. If you haven't heard them, DentonDallasandBeyond.com. They do a weekly podcast about what's happening in and around Denton and then around Dallas and beyond. So it often centers on the beyond part, Las Vegas. But we decided about a year ago that we wanted to get involved in that. And so, yeah, we built a coffin. Hopefully you saw us this year. Ours was the skeleton riding a motorcycle with a sidecar, and it was fun. So
very cool.
Yeah, we had a lot of fun with that.
So, yeah, my man is a jack of all trades. We jam out from time to time. Like I said, he's awesome behind the grill.
Yeah, you're being nice, man.
I mean, he's helping save lives with insurance and things like that, helping protect people. Just all around great dude. So, Lane, you went to A&M.
That's right.
Went down to A&M for a little bit, and then you wound up coming back to Denton.
Well, it was more than a little bit. I was on what they call the extended plan when I went down there. But they eventually let me have a degree, and when I wound up eventually getting that degree, I had a job and was married, so I stayed down there. I went down there in 1986 after graduating Denton High School. And like I said, wound up with a job. I was selling wine at the time. But then in 1998 – Denton called me back. So here I am. I've been back ever since. I doubt that I'll ever leave. You know, it's like Paul Slavens. You know,
yeah.
Paul sings for Ten Hands. Paul did some impromptu tune one night. I remember seeing him over when Dan's was over here on Elm Street. He said, on the spot, he said, Denton sucks you back in. Denton sucks you back in. It does. People come here and they don't leave, and the people who leave come back. It's just a beautiful town, and I can't imagine living anywhere else anymore, you know?
It's a very beautiful town, and I met a lot of beautiful souls here since I've been here. I feel like there's, if you've heard me say this before, excuse me, but there's just such an awesome opportunity for creativity and things like this. I mean, that's why I was really excited to have you on the show, because this is exactly a great example of what I want the show to be about. People out there, local cats that are doing something creative and positive with their work and with their talents. And I mean, you're mean in a wood shop, and here you are helping us musicians step our game up while we're out here doing our thing in the Denton streets.
I love seeing them. I saw a young lady playing one over at the Denton Market here a few weeks ago, and she had it down there. She'd set up, you know, Ellie Meyer, who does the show here on Wednesdays.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Shout out Tuesdays. To you, Ellie.
Yeah. She was running the sound over there, running that show, and this young lady walks up, and I can't remember her name, but I think my daughter, Addison, had just played. And this other young lady walks up, and she's got a tambo toe, and it's stuck in the back of her gig bag on her guitar, and she sets it out there. And she was young. I mean, she's like 15. But I walked up to her, and I said, "Hey, how are you doing?" I said, "I see you got a tambo toe there." She said, "Yeah, I love it." I said, "That's cool. I know the guy that makes those." She said, "Oh, that's awesome." And that was it. That was the end of the conversation.
You know, to bring it on home, I believe that the young lady you're talking about, her name's Lane Elizabeth. Shout out to you, Lane, if you're listening.
That's right. It was Lane Elizabeth.
And I managed to meet her. I met her previously, her and her parents, and I'd seen her talk about the tambo toe. And I said, "Look, you know, I want you to come on my show." And we sat down that particular day that you're talking about. We just weren't there at the same time, I don't think. Or maybe I saw you at the market that day, but I didn't get to see Addie play.
Maybe that was a day that I played and Addie didn't.
I think you're right.
Celeste and I were playing that day.
Which we're going to touch on here in a second.
Okay.
And she says, "You know, yeah, I got this tambo toe, but, you know, my guitarist, my friend, he really wants one." I said, "Well, I'll tell you what. When you come on my show, I'll get you
one."
So I call you up in a tizzy. I'm like, "Hey, man, are you at home?" And you let me come by and pick up a tambo toe to give to her so she could give to her friend. So
see, that's awesome.
Paying it forward.
It's the gift that keeps on giving.
I agree, man. So Lane, like I said, is a jack of many things, and one of them is he's a musician as well, and he is half of a duo.
That's right.
That is called Kitty and the Beard with our friend Celeste.
Correct.
And so y'all have built up an hour yet, or y'all working towards this still?
I think we could fill an hour. You know, first of all, for you to call me a musician is being nice. guitar is not my first language, but I'm a drummer. My musical history is as a drummer, a percussionist. But I learned many years ago, playing in many bands, there'd always be an after party, you know, somewhere. Even if it was just hanging out behind the stage and plucking out a few more songs, but it'd always be with an acoustic guitar, you know, or it'd always be on somebody's porch at midnight. Well, man, you can't play drums on the porch at midnight. The neighbors don't like that. So, yeah, I picked up a little guitar and then a few years ago, I met Celeste and her husband, Michael, and I believe it was New Year's Eve, as a matter of fact. New Year's Eve is right around the corner. And the four of us, she and Michael and Amy and I, were sitting out in the garage. And I picked up a guitar, and I was just messing around, and she started singing. I had never heard her sing before. And I was like, "You've been hiding that from me? You've been hiding that voice from me." She has a fabulous voice.
Yes, she does.
And so from that, we just decided, hey, we've got this cool little musical vibe together, and just started putting songs together. And, you know, we played many an open mic night around, played Bone Doggies at LSA. We played Caleb's over at Audacity. Ellie had us out at the market a few times, and we've done a few other little spots here and there. So to say we're all over the place would be incorrect, but, you know, if you invite us, we'll play. And yeah, we could do an hour, I'm sure.
You can see him around. You just never know when you're going to see the Kitty and the Beard doing their thing.
Well, if you're friends with me on Facebook, I always post it, you know, tell you where we're going to be. And I don't have anything in the near future, but hopefully towards mid to late January, we'll start getting back out there again.
Yeah.
It's just a busy season, you know.
No doubt. No doubt. All this traveling. You just got back from Mexico. You're about to go on another trip.
Actually, you know what? An aside, I wasn't really in Mexico.
Where were you?
I don't know. I was here. I was here. Facebook thought I was in Mexico. So I popped
Lane,
up one day.
I thought you were in Mexico,
no,
man.
No, Amy and I were in Mexico in June of this year, and it popped up this photo from Mexico when we were there, and I thought, you know what? We're just going to play this out. So I posted some more photos from that Mexico trip.
Wow.
Just said, hey, don't bother me. I'm in Mexico. But no, I was right here in beautiful Denton, Texas, man.
The whole time.
Yeah.
You had me fooled, man. Because y'all went to Vegas or something like that.
Yeah, we were in Vegas. When was that? September. And actually, we got the trip of a lifetime coming up week from Friday. We're gonna go to Cuba.
Oh, man.
While we still can. We had an opportunity to put this trip together. And there's a bunch of us from here in Denton that are going to go, and we're going to go do a cultural and cigar exchange.
Yes.
Yeah.
That should be a grand old time, man. So, and I can't wait for you to come back with some stories and some pleasantries.
Oh yeah.
From old Cuba.
Oh yeah.
That'll be fun. So we're gonna take a small break. When we come back, me and Lane are gonna demonstrate what this tambo toe can do and jam on some tunes. I hope that's all right with you. You're listening to the Creation Sensation here on DentonRadio.com.
All right.
Education at Texas Women's University, the largest public university primarily for women. TWU graduates are leaders in healthcare, business, and education. Learn more at www.twu.edu.
Welcome back to the show. You're tuning into the Creation Sensation. Appreciate you for joining us. You can hear this show live on DentonRadio.com. If you just go to the URL or if you go to the app, which we have available. And, of course, it's free 99, people. So go ahead and download that. I know it works for Apple and Android, so no excuses there. If you guys are on Facebook, you can check out our Facebook page there, DentonRadio.com, and you can see the live feed as we do these interviews every Wednesday from 7 till 8 here in the Discover Denton Welcome Center. We're located down here on the square at 111 West Hickory Street. Literally, I mean, everything's by the courthouse, but we are right beside big old LSA, and Norman Roscoe is on the other side of us. So come see us. It's a wonderful, wonderful place, the Discover Denton Welcome Center. It's very, very Denton-y. We got a lot going on in here. We got merchandise that's all local. We've got Denton experts that can help you guys figure out what can I do today or this weekend. Yes, yes, yes. They're always here with smiling faces and lots of different kept secrets that I didn't even know about. And I've lived here for 10 years, and I know that we could probably rock your mind even if you've lived here for 40 years. There's so many nooks and crannies to be discovered here. So back with my man Lane here. We've been talking about the tambo toe, and I figured that we could put this bad boy into use, play you guys some tunes. I don't think that you'll mind. At least I hope you won't. We've had the opportunity of many, many a jam session, and I always like it when my man plays his harmonica with me, so that's what I asked him.
I had put these away for a few months, and I just kind of let life get in the way.
Uh-huh.
And so when we got together last night and said, I'd like you to play harmonica, I was like, oh, my goodness, man.
Would you?
I don't know. So there's a little bit of this in my background, but, you know, it'll be fun. So
exactly.
What you got in mind?
I felt like what we could start with was maybe a little bit of some Last Dance.
Oh, yeah.
She grew up in Indiana town, had a good-looking mama. Never was around, but she grew up tall. She grew up right with the Indiana boys on the Indiana night. She came down here at the age of 18. She blew the boys away, she was more than they'd seen. I was introduced and we began grooving. She said, I dig you, baby, but I gotta keep it moving on. Again.
I've been told you never slow down and you never go old. I'm tired of screwing up, I'm tired of being down. Tired of myself and I'm tired of this town. Oh my, my, oh hey, yeah. Baby, put on that party dress. Buy me a drink and sing me a song. You better take me as I am because I can't stay long. Last dance for Mary Jane. One more time to kill the pain. I feel summer creeping in and I'm tired of this town again. There's pigeons down in Market Square. She's standing in her underwear. She's looking down from hotel room. Nightfall will be coming soon. Oh my, my, oh hey, yeah. Baby, put on that party dress. It was too cold to cry when I woke up alone. I hit the last number and walked down the road. Last dance with Mary Jane. One more time to kill the flame. I feel summer creeping in and I'm tired of this town again.
So, Lane, let me ask you, man, where did you guys come up with the name for Timbertoe?
Well, Mike engraved it on the very first one, so I guess we were kind of married to it.
Yeah?
I mean, it's a foot-operated tambourine. You know, it's a percussive instrument. You kick with your toe. It's basically a tambourine in a wood block. I mean, it's just kind of catchy. Tambo toe, you know?
So I've never gone through... Because this is patented, right?
It is patented.
So what's the how difficult was that process? How long did it take? What all did that entail,
man? Well,
I
actually brought a copy of the patent, man.
Really?
Check this out. I don't know if I've ever showed you this before. But I got to put my glasses on to see it. Here's what's interesting. Who was the president when the patent office was? Was it Grover Cleveland? I believe Grover Cleveland was the president. If I'm wrong, you can send me hate mail to lane@tambotoe.com. But whomever was the president at the time said they were the opening of the patent office says, I don't know why we need this because everything that's been invented is going to be invented is already here. But since then, we have number 8,669,453 BR is our Tambo or our patent number. That's what it looks like, man. That's
wow.
That's the patent. It's about 6 pages, and the application to do it was several pages. We actually hired a guy who's a patent agent, a patent attorney, to help us do this. And we met him at another friend's house here in town, I want to say on a New Year's Eve one night. And I told him about this thing we had, and he says, that sounds kind of interesting. So we took him to lunch one day, showed it to him, showed him what we're doing. He says, you know what? This, I think, I can make work. And normally you file the application. To answer one of your questions, how long did it take? It was about 2 years from the time we filed till the time we actually got the patent.
Really? So a two-year process.
Well, I'm told it usually takes longer than that because normally, you know, you'll file, as I understand it, the way it works, you'll file similar items that could say, hey, this might infringe on that, but ours is just different enough that it doesn't step on any of these guys.
Because I can see, like, you guys have – step by step, like how it's supposed to work,
right?
What you're supposed to do.
Yeah.
So if something's kind of similar, you can go to it and say,
that's right,
that follows exactly what this patent says. So,
yeah.
Wow.
So, I mean, it's neat to have. I keep forgetting. I need to make a copy and hang it on my office wall because I've got a patent, man. I've cool.
Yeah, my boy's got a patent.
Got a patent. So I don't know if that'll ever happen again in my lifetime, but I got one.
You got one.
Here.
You on the board?
I'm on.
You're on the board,
man. I'm on the board, man. Got some score.
Oh, man. So yeah, I guess if you didn't really have a say in the name, it was just kind of already there.
The name just makes sense.
It does,
you know?
Though.
I can't imagine it naming it anything else now. You know, it's just easy. You know, we make our little T-shirts like I'm wearing today and various other little tchotchkes and knickknacks.
Do y'all sell merch on the website there so somebody could get a T-shirt if they want it?
There's actually a link that if you wanted to, it goes to another provider called Cafe Press, cafepress.com. So you can actually go and buy anything you want with a Tambo Toe logo on it.
Really?
You know, the logo's trademarked, the name is trademarked, and the instrument itself is patented. So, I mean, it's a deal we made with them. We'll be out at Jazz Fest again in April.
Yes.
It'll be our fifth or sixth year to be out there, I think. And I don't know if we'll have T-shirts for sale. We may, because I've made a nice relationship with some guys here in town. Nice dudes, Servicing Craft. They've done some stuff for us. So we may. We'll just have to see. But if you need one now, you can go to the website, tambotoe.com, and there's a little click through for Cafe Press. If you need one right away, you can get it.
That's tight.
Yeah.
That is tight. So what else is next for you? Just on the big scale, you got some. I know your Cuba trip, but what else is up?
Well, the gig you did in Austin 2 years ago is coming up in a couple of weeks. I got that to do. You mentioned our NAFA family, our insurance.
So let me cut you off for a second, yeah, because I forgot the best part about that particular trip I got to go on with you guys is that, you know, my man here, like I said, he looked very mayoral from the first time I saw him. And I just knew this dude was somebody important. And when he invites me down, he says, "Hey, so listen, I'm the president of the Texas chapter for NAFA." And I didn't even know yet. Like I said, there were 500 people there, and my man was the prez over all of those bad boys.
Well, it was a great honor, you know, to be elected by those people to represent them. So it's something that I'll always wear as a big feather in my cap, you know.
Yeah,
very, very high moment in my life, my career.
And I'm glad I got to be there to see you for while you were doing the rain,
well,
man.
Well, thank you, man. Thank you very much.
So I just wanted to cut you off and give you a little praise on
that. Well, I appreciate that. You're very kind.
So I don't know if you remember what you were saying before I cut you off. You said something about NAFA.
Oh, yeah, the same gig.
Okay.
Same hotel we were at when you and I were down there 2 years
ago. So y'all always just go down every year? Same gig?
Every other year. Every other year when the Texas legislature is in session.
Gotcha.
So, you know, we just elected a new guy from this district, Dr. Lynn Stuckey.
Okay.
That's Texas House District 64, I believe. He actually called me Monday morning.
Really?
Yeah. I thought that was weird, and I had just barely gotten out of bed. He probably picked up on that. So, yeah, we go down, and we meet all the legislators when they're early in the session and just say, "Hey, remember us. Here's what we do.
Right.
We're here to solve problems and not create them." So that's why we go down there every other year.
I can dig it.
Yeah.
You want to play another song?
Sure.
All right.
What do you want to do?
Let's hit this. It's Ray Charles, man.
That was a different key.
What did we go to? Did we go to
what key are you in?
I think I was doing it in A last night.
So I'm a D.
But if you want, we can do it in G. Mm.
Now, oh, hey, remember last night I told you I was going to clean these harmonicas up?
Did you?
I did. And I also said be careful when you do that because they're very fragile.
Uh-huh.
So I busted a reed out of this one. That's okay. You'll just hear it when there's space. Like, what was it? Louis Armstrong said that music is in the spaces?
Yes.
Yeah. You're about to have some spaces.
All right. So, I can dig that.
Yeah.
All right, let me make sure we got all of this going. And we do. Well, I got a woman way over town. She's good to me. Oh, yeah. I got a woman way over town. She's good to me. Oh, yeah.
Nice.
She gives me the heartbeat when I'm in need. Yeah, she's a kind of friend indeed. I got a woman way over town. She's good to me. Oh, yeah. She says,
loving early in the morning just for me. Oh yeah, she says I love it so early in the morning just for me. She says I love it just for me. And she loves me, loves me, loves me so tenderly. I got a woman way over town. She's good to me.
She pick up some spaces.
All right, hit it.
To love me both day and night, never grumbles, fusses, and always treats me right. Never running in the streets, leaving me all alone, 'cause this woman, she sticks to me like the scent of good cologne. I got a woman way over town, she's good to me. Oh yeah, I got a woman way over town, she's good to me. She gives me money when I'm in need. Yeah, she's the kind of friend indeed. I got a woman way over town, she's good to me. Oh yeah, don't you know she's alright? No, she's alright. Oh yeah. No, she's alright. No, she's alright. No, she's alright. That's for you, Papa Don. Because
that's it.
You always tell me about Ray Charles and how high regard you hold that man. So that's for you, my man.
I think that was actually Mama Susan asked you to do Ray Charles.
Mama Susan did.
That's all right. Don digs it too.
He does dig it. He's asked me on a separate occasion, you got some Ray Charles?
Oh, yeah.
And of course I do. So you guys have gone, I don't want to say all over the world. I only know Nicaragua, the other places that you guys have been. So Lane and his father, Don, we call them the Booze Brothers. Not for any reason, but because it's their last name.
Well, it sounds cool.
And it sounds cool.
Yeah.
So you guys are connoisseurs of many different things, one of which being cigars.
We love cigars.
And y'all had an opportunity to go down to Nicaragua.
That's right. It was actually 2 years ago, this upcoming week. It was actually the Dons. We also call Papa Don the Don because it sounds cool. Makes him sound dangerous, which he's not. Unless he's left to his own devices, but he's otherwise a big teddy bear. It was actually Don's 70th birthday, and so a group of us went down there from another local establishment here, Cigar Frogs, a bunch of us who are frequent partakers of that establishment. They put together a trip, and it was hosted by one of the labels that they represent in that family, the A.J. Fernandez family, and they hosted us down there. And that was a lot of fun. I would do that again in a heartbeat. It was just, I don't call it a life-changing experience, but it was something that...
You're going to remember
of course,
for the remainder of your life.
Of course. And it made big brand loyal people out of us, too, you know?
Yes.
So pretty much anything that factory makes, we're going to try it out and probably enjoy it.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of another reason why you guys are going to Cuba, right?
We're going under the current agreement that's called a cultural exchange program, and so we will go and do what the government requires. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but our hosts, who are actually a couple of guys out of Atlanta, they do a radio show out of Atlanta called Smooth Draws. You can hear them online too. They're actually the hosts and the guides of the trip, Gary and Nick. Their last names escape me for the moment, but they've been going down there once a month pretty regularly. And this may be their last trip of this sort. You know, we'll see when our regime changes on December 20th, which is right after we get back.
Yeah, so y'all better just enjoy it for everything that
absolutely,
it is.
Absolutely, man. I'm really, really looking forward to the opportunity to go down there and check this out. So if you've seen any shows about Cuba, you see them, all these old classic American cars driving around. Part of the gig on this tour is those cars that you see are hired to pick us up at the airport. All these old classic convertibles.
Y'all going
to
be rolling around in 50s?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. And just about everywhere we go, they're going to be rocking us around in these old classic American cars, man.
I can't wait to see
it's
going to
be cool. I'm really excited about it.
That should be a lot of fun, man.
And we'll bring back some Cuban rum. Last night you had Nicaraguan rum.
Yes,
we're
indeed.
We're going to bring back some Cuban rum and some delicious Cuban cigars.
Wow.
Yeah.
Much to look ahead to in 2017,
much,
people.
Man. Much.
Wow. Well, let's play another tune, my man.
What you got?
Let's do this Bob Dylan tune.
What key was I in? What key are you in?
Did we say it was F?
You're in F?
I'll be in D.
Okay, I'm still a G harp.
Okay.
Good. Yeah, we're good to go.
Cool. To sit and wonder why, babe, you don't know by now. And ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, it'll never do somehow. If your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on, but don't think twice, alright. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe, the light I never know. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe, I'm on the dark side of the road. But I wish there was something you would do or say to try to make me change my mind and stay. We never did too much talking anyway, but don't think twice, alright. And calling out my name, gal, like you never done before. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, I can't hear you anymore. I'm a thinking and a wandering, walking down the road. I once loved a woman, a child, I'm told. I gave my heart, but she wanted my soul. But don't think twice, alright. So long, honey, baby. Where I'm bound, I can't tell. Goodbye's too good of a word, babe, so I say thee fairly well. I ain't saying that you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kinda wasted my sweet and precious time. but don't think twice, alright. So don't think twice, my peeps. That was some Bob Dylan. We did our thing tonight, man. Got to hang out.
That was cool. It's always fun to jam with you, Dunshay.
Hey, likewise, always. Brother. You keep it up and keep those things not dusty. And you have to show me how to clean it like we were talking about last night, man, you know, because you can pop that bad boy open.
Yeah.
And apparently.
I'll be popping over to McBride's tomorrow to replace that D. You know, I try to recycle them as much as possible. They've gotten expensive.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure they used to be even much cheaper probably before I was born.
Oh,
but
man. I think when I started buying them, they were like $15, and now they're like $35, $40, something like
for
that.
For a good one.
Yeah. Well, you got to play a good one, man. Yeah. It's like, you know, the different any quality of instrument or type of instrument, you know, the better the quality, the better you feel about it, the better you're going to sound, right?
Yes, indeed.
That's why, you know, we come back to the maintaining absolute primo quality on our tempo toes, you know?
Yes. So, again, in case anybody is interested in these bad boys, lane@tambotoe.com.
Actually, you don't even have to contact me directly. You can go to tambotoe.com
okay. And
get them there. You can get them at amazon.com. You can get them at reverb.com. If you catch us at the Dallas Guitar Show. Actually, we're not going to be at the Dallas Guitar Show, but we'll be at the Arlington Guitar Show or Guitarlington. That's not till October. But we have our Denton Arts and Jazz Festival coming up in April.
Yes, indeed.
And we'll be out there. So if you're a player, come by. If you haven't played one before, come by, because we're going to make you play. If
yep.
you come in and you're a player, you're going to play a song with us.
Yes,
That's
indeed.
That's part of the fun.
And chances are, you know, there'll be other musicians yeah. around there doing the same thing. So come by, try one of these out.
Yeah.
He'll have plenty to choose from, I assure you.
Yeah, in the interim, if you need one soon, probably tambotoe.com would be your fastest and least expensive way to get one here real soon.
Man, that's awesome.
Man, thank you so much.
It's been a pleasure to have you on, Lane. Like I said,
my
I feel
pleasure.
Like this is the best way I could have thought to close out my year as far as Creation Sensations concerned. I appreciate you for everything you've done, all the times we've gotten to hang out. You're a good man.
Well, this is a highlight of my year, man, so thank you.
Cool. Well, we're ending it on a high note. For all you peeps out there listening, hey, y'all be safe this weekend. I know there's a lot going on. Have a lot of fun, but be safe, because we're trying to bring in this new year, getting to the next level. That's what we want to focus on when we come back. Let's take it to that next level of whatever we're trying to do, whoever we're trying to be. This will be your time to really start to get towards that goal. So you guys stay encouraged, stay inspired, and be creative, people. That's what it's about. Peace out.